Let's keep it in Boston. Tyler Seguin, Rich Peverley heading from Boston to Dallas. Huge trade. Loui Eriksson, three others heading back the other way. Seguin had a goal and seven assists in the Bruins Stanley Cup final loss to the Blackhawks. Let's take a look at this a little bit more in detail as one of the NHL's youngest stars is on the move. It's now official. Seven players, two prominent ones swapping sweaters. It's Seguin, Peverley, and Ryan Button to the Stars. Loui Eriksson, Joe Morrow, Reilly Smith, Matt Fraser round out the deal. TSN hockey insider Pierre LeBrun of ESPN.com says that Eriksson agreed to waive his no trade clause earlier on Thursday, helping to get the deal done. Joining us now on SportsCenter is Darren Drager, who first broke news of the trade. Darren, Tyler Seguin, 21 years old, entering the first year of a six-year deal, one of the brightest young players in the NHL. So why are the Bruins parting ways with him?
You know, this is a difficult one, and it comes down to finances. When you look at the cap space that the Boston Bruins have, the cap space that they need, you know, they're looking at options. Rich Peverley most definitely was on the block prior to this. There was a lot of speculation last weekend over whether or not Tyler Seguin might be in the mix as well. But, you know, Boston needs to add some pieces. So this was a very difficult move, transaction for Peter Chiarelli, the general manager of the Bruins, to make, considering Seguin is a 21-year-old, has all kinds of upside. He is, when you look at the age of player, no player same age as Tyler Seguin has played more games than he has at the NHL level. So this is about dollars and cents in Boston.
No doubt about it. 21, best yet still to come. Meanwhile, let's talk about Loui Eriksson. He's got 3 years left on a six-year deal, about 25 and a half mil total. What kind of player is Boston getting here in return?
Well, they're getting a scoring winger, and you can always add some offense. Not that Tyler Seguin did not provide that offense, but I think anyone who knows Tyler Seguin also understands that he is more suited to the center of the ice. He sees himself as a natural center. Not going to get that conflict with Loui Eriksson. He will play the wing. He will happily play the wing in Boston's top six. So you go back to the days when Brad Richards was the center for the Dallas Stars. He loved playing with Loui Eriksson, and I suspect either Patrice Bergeron or David Krejci will have that same experience when Eriksson suits up in Boston next year.
All right, before I let you go, who do you think got the better end of this?
Well, that's a good question. I think that this is a deal that fits both. But, you know, when you're moving out, again, a 21-year-old player in Tyler Seguin, who seems to have so much upside given the experience at such a young age that he has earned with the Boston Bruins, if I was going to give the edge, again, all the prospects that the Bruins acquire in making this deal, I still look at Tyler Seguin being the best player in the deal. So in that regard, I'll give the edge to Dallas.
It was a thrilling NHL postseason, and it appears the offseason is off to a bang as well. Darren Drager broke the news with a huge trade. Tyler Seguin heading to Dallas in a seven-player deal. Darren, thanks for joining us here on SportsCenter.